Will you notice verse 10? Now therefore the sword shall never depart from thine house, because thou hast despised me, and hast taken the wife of Uriah the Hittite to be thy wife. Now may I say, Christian friend, when the question rises, can you commit sin as a Christian? And the answer is yes, you can. But when you do, you despise God. That's what you do. God says that. I didn't say it. And God says, I won't let you get by with it. You're my child. David's not going to get by with it. Listen to what God says. Here, the sword will never depart from thy house. And because you took the wife Uriah the Hittite to be thy wife, thus saith the Lord, behold, I'll raise up evil against thee out of thine own house. And friends, in the next chapter, a scandal breaks out among the children of David, and it's an awful thing. Heartbreak to this man. You will never find him whimpering or crying out to God about it, because David knew that God was putting a lash on his back. All David wanted is, as the hart panteth after the water brook, so panteth my soul after thee, O God. He says, I'll take thy wives before thine eyes, give them unto thy neighbor, and he shall lie with thy wives in the sight of this son. For thou didst it secretly, but I'll do this thing before all Israel and before the sun. Now listen to David. Now, David could have done many things, as we've said. Other rulers of the world would never have acted like David. David said unto Nathan, I have sinned against the Lord. And Nathan said unto David, the Lord also hath put away thy sin. Thou shalt not die. David should have died, of course, for this. Howbeit, because by this deed thou hast given occasion to the enemies of the Lord to blaspheme, the child also that's born unto thee shall surely die. And friends, they still blaspheme God because of what David did. When I was pastoring downtown Los Angeles on many occasions, I had some vile person, unbeliever, skeptic, come and say to me, how could God choose a man like David? And they would leer at you, you know. God says you caused the enemy to blaspheme, still blasphemes. God's going to take him to the woodshed. And Nathan departed unto his house. And the Lord struck the child that Uriah's wife bare unto David, and it was very sick. David therefore besought God for the child. David fasted and went in and lay all night upon the earth. The elders of his house arose and went to him to raise him up from the earth. He would not, neither did he eat bread with him. He went before God and pled with God to spare the little fellow's life. And finally, why, they brought word to him that the child was dead. And verse 19, but when David saw that his servants whispered, David perceived that the child was dead. Therefore David said unto his servants, is the child dead? And they said, he's dead. Then David arose from the earth, washed and anointed himself, changed his apparel, came into the house of the Lord and worshiped. Then he came to his own house. And when he required, they set bread before him and he did eat. Now, all of them are astounded. He had been in sackcloth and ashes. Now the child is dead and he should mourn, and he's not mourning.